I play Greg Sanders, the DNA lab guy on CSI. I'm younger than most people that work there, but I kind of attribute that to probably being pretty smart, maybe a little bit ahead of my class, whatever. So I serve as more or less the court jester on the show, I think. They come to me whenever they need results on any type of blood or saliva, any body fluid, and then I usually, you know, trace it back to the source. And in doing so, you know, maybe throw out a few jokes or, you know, dance around or something. Before we, you know, shoot any technical scenes, I try to, you know, get as much information as I can from the on-set expert. And if there's any words I can't pronounce, obviously, like, I try to work that out before we roll. But more than that, like, I kind of have my own techniques for trying to make, you know, just information sound interesting. And that's just by kind of, like, playing a little bit of subtext, you know, rather than, you know, really trying to work the words. You know, you just kind of, you know, there's different ways of saying everything. And so I try to say it in a way that doesn't sound too jargony, you know. So I guess, you know, I'm glad that it works, but it just shows that you're connected to what you're saying rather than trying to sound like you're, you know, a scientist. You're maybe talking about something you really know through these words. And then with Grissom, there's, I don't know, some type of competition thing. I know he has that pretty much with everyone, but between the two of us, I think it's different because there is such an age gap. But a lot of the technology that I'm using is pretty current, you know, so he wasn't necessarily ahead of me in learning how to, you know, break DNA code and stuff like that because we both, you know, started studying it at the same time. I don't know. So I definitely like what has kind of grown between both characters because, I mean, with Catherine, I get to flirt, and with Grissom, I get to, you know, kind of, you know, duke it out a little bit, you know, vocally. So. It's cool when you get to see someone that doesn't even speak English, you know, think you're funny or, you know, if you can entertain them, you know, we have like a pretty cool network, you know, set up, you know, and the show is definitely like taking off because of the same reasons it's taking off here. You know, it's just that there's good characters and there's good storylines and, you know, it appeals to people everywhere. I mean, everyone's interested in, you know, what happens at, you know, after you die or, you know, what happens, you know, in criminal investigation, stuff like that. So, I mean, it definitely has universal appeal. My advice to people trying to, you know, overdub my voice, I would just say be sure to breathe, you know, and kind of try to speak from your diaphragm. Try not to sound too nasally because I tend to. So if you can improve on it at all, I'd appreciate it. One of the most bizarre scenes I've ever done was an episode where we were looking through a showgirl headdress for some hair follicles, and I had found the match and jump out into the hallway doing the boom boom dance kick line with the headdress on my head and get caught by Catherine and Grissom and, you know, try to regain composure and step out. But when I originally read it, I couldn't believe that I was seeing that on the page. And I was just, you know, at first I was just embarrassed about doing it in front of the crew. And then right before we rolled, one of the stand-ins came up to me and said, "Hey man, you realize that 30 million people are gonna see you do this?" And that's when I just kind of, you know, threw all caution to the wind and tried to forget about it. And now it's just kind of snowballed, turned into something more than, you know, I'd ever expected. But I'm down with it.
You want to take that thing off your head, Greg? It's evidence.
Cool your jets, Cap. I already got all the evidence out of it. Now, it's all woman. Did you ever wear one of these when you were dancing?
I wore nothing but skin.
Ooh. I compared the DNA from the tooth with the hair follicles found inside the headdress. I think we have a match, sir. And I think we may have a homicide. Excuse me.